are you here for?
Well, I'm here for,
concussion settlement.
No, you're not.
What's going on, y'all? Grind a little bit back in this thing again, man. And today I wanted to come with something a little bit different, man. I wanted to come with an article, man, instead of a video. And today's subject is not about the thoughts, not about the, you know, just kind of about just some general stuff, man. And the article is called "How the NFL is Stacking the Deck Against Black Ex-Players in a Concussion Settlement." And I mean, I want to know how they stacking the deck against us, man. Like, you know, what's going on? Cause you know I am black. But yeah, man. Before we get into the video, man, go on, like, comment, subscribe. Or the article, like, comment, subscribe. If you do all three, man, you know I'll be grateful. If you do just one, I'll still be thankful, man. Go on, share the video, man. Share something that you liked about my channel. Share anything, man. Like, cause I'm trying to get to 1,000, man, so I can start getting a little bit of money, and that's gonna keep me going, keep me spurred, keep me right, man. And you know how that is, man. When you're working and you ain't really getting a, I guess you ain't really getting the resultates that you want out of it. You start kind of being like, oh man, I ain't saying I'm like that, but yeah, just you know, share the video for me, man. Look out for me, man. I know some of y'all really be supporting, so go on, share something for me. Let me know something. And yeah, also, man, as far as, you know, playing football and everything, have you played football before? Have you ever had a concussion before? You know, if you did play football, did you walk away with some type of damage to your brain or trauma or something like that? Also, man, are you gonna let women, men, whatever, are you gonna let your children play football? Are you gonna let them do anything that involves contact or repeated brain trauma? Like, let me know something. But here's the start of the article. The NFL knowingly ignored the effects of head trauma on its players for decades, obfuscating data that showed the effects all too clearly, and hiring Dr. Elliot Pellman to oversee the league's mild traumatic brain injury committee. He sounds like a bitch ass. It was formed in 1994. Pellman, a Guadalajara educated rheumatologist with no expertise in head trauma, who was also a former commissioner, Paul Tagliabue's, or whatever the hell his name is, personal physician. He was a better commissioner than Roger Goodell, because at least he'll let you do a celebration and shit. Roger Goodell, we got down. He's like the cancel culture of NFL commissioners. Here's the second paragraph. Pellman, who became one of the worst shields imaginable, and his colleagues wrote in January 2005 that returning to play after concussion does not involve significant risk of second injury either in the same game or during the season. The group also stated repeatedly that there was no evidence of worsening injury or chronic cumulative effects of multiple MTBIs in NFL players. Alright, so how many of y'all have actually had a concussion and like know what it feels like, man? Like I've had a concussion in a football game and it doesn't feel right.
Who there?
I'm not gonna lie, like, but back when I was playing, they weren't telling us that you had a concussion, that you shouldn't be coming back. Like, they were just like, oh, get back in there. Go get in there. And I got down, like, it's like, when you have a concussion, it's like somebody's talking to you, and it's like, you're hearing what they're saying, but it's like, you can't, like, you're, like, not really getting, like, you're not really taking it in or something like that, and, like, you're forgetting, like, very simple stuff. Like, I remember asking people, like, you know, what are the plays and stuff like that. Like, this is a play where I get the ball and I'm still asking, like, hey man, what do I do on this play? And then, like, they're telling me, oh, you do this and do this, and it's like, I'm still barely taking it in and everything like that. But yeah, man, like, what's your experience with a concussion? What's your experience with anything like that? Let me know, have you had anything like that happen, man? Here we go. It is not an exaggeration to state that without Pellman in charge of the committee, and with a more qualified and more independent physician at the helm, NFL players would have known the full measure of their eventual fates years before they did. The NFL's eventual settlement with more than 4,000 former players and their family was a result of a series of lawsuits seeking to stamp the NFL with its own liability in this regard. One of the conditions of the settlement was a gag order on years of malfeasance, a huge boon for the league that would rather forget Pellman ever existed in a public relations sense. Unbelievably, or perhaps all too believably, the NFL is still moving the goalposts in a figurative sense. Her report of Mary blah blah blah, I'm not going to say her name, you can read that. The ex-players who are supposed to receive benefits from the $1 billion settlement eventually reached with the NFL are not receiving those benefits as the rate that they should be. And one of the primary reasons is a repugnant practice called race norming. Now we get into the meat and potatoes of this whole argument, this whole article. And then it says, as the AP report points out, race norming is sometimes used in medicine as a rough proxy for socioeconomic factors that can affect someone's health. Experts in neurology say that way it's used in the NFL setting is too simplistic and restrictive and has the effect of systematically discriminating against black players. The NFL in this case has insisted on using a scale that presupposed that black people have lower cognitive skills. Thus, it is more difficult for black ex-players, the majority of the players who should receive benefits, to prove cognitive decline as a result of head trauma. Wow. Wow, they really think we dumb out here in these streets, man. Well, if you black, they think you dumb. But yeah, man, we make up most of the league, man. We're the reason that everybody wants to watch it. Like if we left, like nobody would want to watch it, man. I think that's why everybody's always talking about start your own league, start your own team. Like, but you know, we got all these little soft bros in the NFL that they got no backbone or nothing like that. They don't want to do nothing. Like you know, you see how they let that boy Kaepernick go outside like he did. Didn't nobody else stand up with him except for a couple, two, three people. And then you know he never came back. He never recovered. And now we got these folks talking about, yeah, you black guys are stupid. You already were dumb before you got in. So you don't get any money. It's like, bro, like, that shit is whack, bro. That shit is lame as hell, man. Like, you put your life on the line for these folks. Like, really? Like, NFL is a game. But, bro, you definitely, like, if you play football, bro, you for sure for a fact know that, hey, bro, like, this shit is not really a joke, bro. Like, boxing is, like, for sure not a joke. But NFL also is not a joke either, man. Like every time you collide with somebody, you have a chance to goddamn messing your brain up a little bit, goddamn. So yeah, I really don't like that, man. I don't know, what do they say about like a white guy who's like a, I don't know, he's like a frat guy or something like that. Is his cognitive game low too? Like you know, what do they say? What are they trying? I don't know. This shit is just really whack and racist, bro. Like the NFL, man. The NFL further. It's just making me just not like them every time I hear something new about them. Like, from Roger Goodell being commissioner with his whack ass to Tom Brady goddamn beating the Falcons goddamn back in a couple years ago when we had the lead to goddamn shit, man, the Colin Kaepernick thing, man, and yeah, man, all these little whack ass racist owners and everything like that. But that's just, I don't know, man. What do you feel about that, man? Do you think that What do you think would happen if everybody who was African American decided they wanted to leave? Let me know. But let's continue. Norming by race is not the stance that the NFL ought to take, Dr. Art Kaplan, a New York University medical ethicist, told the AP. It continues to look as if it's trying to exclude people rather than trying to do what's right, which is to help people that clinically have obvious and severe disability. He noted that the long history of racial bias in medicine includes the long-held myth that black people feel less pain. People are still doing that. I can't believe, like, I don't know. That just kind of shows, like, all this, like, a lot of this stuff that, like, was set up, like, way before black people were able to, like, even have, like, basic human rights. It's kind of, like, null and void to me. Like, it's like, bro, we should be, like, some shit should be switched around, man. Let me know what y'all think about that. Then also we've got, there's always been this race norming in medicine that has been problematic because it's tied in too closely to racism. Former NFL running back Ken Jenkins, I don't know who that is, but I'm gonna find out, who played with the Detroit Lions in 1983 and 1980. That's why I don't know who he is, because he played for the Lions. Mike, you might know. And then the Washington Redskins in 1985 and 1986. Well, that's really why I don't know, because he's old as a bitch. This is back before I was even thought of. Recently, along with his wife, Amy Lewis, delivered 50,000 petitions demanding equal treatment for black players to senior U.S. District Judge Anita B. Broaddy in Philadelphia, who was overseeing the settlement and who recently dismissed a civil rights lawsuit based on race norming brought by NFL players Najee Davenport and Kevin Henry. Najee Davenport sounds familiar, but I don't know. Here we go. I guess this is somebody talking. My reaction was, well, here we go again, said Jenkins to the AP, who said that he has experienced no cognitive decline and is now an insurance executive. It's the same old nonsense for black folks to have to deal with some insidious, convoluted deals that are being made. Most of the NFL's approximately 20,000 retirees are black, and to date, only about 25% of the more than 2,000 retired players have sought awards for the early to moderate dementia based on the testing program have qualified. Wow, crazy. Several lawyers representing black ex-players have asked for details on how the $800 million in payouts have broken across racial lines, but are still waiting for answers. And you know why they ain't giving answers, because they're going to pay your boy goddamn J.J. Watt when he get finished, and he have a little bit of brain injury. He walk around like goddamn finish him. They going to be like, oh, yeah, we'll pay you $100 million. But then we got, let's see, racism may have had a benign origin, but it quickly morphed into a tool that can be used to help the folks in power save money, Jenkins concluded. Until and unless the NFL is able to come up with a compelling reason for using race norming in this fashion, Jenkins' point is difficult, if not impossible, to argue. I guess that's the end of the article. I'm going to end it there. That is the end of the article. But yeah, man, what do y'all think about this whole thing, man? Like,
Hey, Fred Kaufman here, Channel 2 Action News, and we got a chilling story today. Atlanta native Jaquavius Austin has recently filed for a concussion lawsuit. He played 12 years in the NFL. He was a graduate of Harvard, first in his class, and now he can't remember a thing.
Kaepernick back in the NFL. That's gonna be a no. Let me send out a blast email to everyone. Kaepernick will not get back in the NFL. He stood up for black people's rights. We don't have rights. Do not hire him for your team. Sit.
What's going on, Mr. Goodell?
Hey, what's up, Jaquavius? What brings you here?
You look great, man. What's been going on, man? You look amazing. You don't look any worse for wear. I couldn't tell anything's going on.
I do work out, man. Did I go to the gym today? I gotta go to the gym later today. I gotta go.
Well, what are you here for?
Well, I'm here for
concussion settlement.
No, you're not. Well, that dude, what are you really here for?
That DeVry education is catching up to you, man.
No, I went to Harvard.
No, man, you went to DeVry. Remember class of 2008? I remember the Seahawks drafted you first round.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Technology.
Yeah, I mean, you did say you were gonna take me to lunch, so I'm kind of waiting on that Ruth Chris that you were talking about.
We did talk about Ruth Chris. You're right. We did talk about Ruth Chris.
Let me see. Hold on, I got an email. Atlanta Falcons. We'd like to hire Kaepernick. Nope. What was I saying? You said you were gonna take me to Ruth Chris and give me some dinner. You said you're paying.
Never too much to pay for my boy Goodell.
That shit is crazy, man. They really think, like, the people that make up their league, the people that are the reason that the asses are filled in the seats, they are trying to play these people, man. Talking about some, you were dumb before you even came in. You're stupid. So this this dementia or this messed up brain that you're having. You already had that shit. Like, bro, that's so disrespectful. And I don't care, like, if you're like some white guy on here trying to be like, stop making it racist. Stop making it about race. It is about race. Shut the hell up, Brad. Shut the fuck up, you retard. But yeah, man, I can't stand when people act like that shit is not like when people act like racism is not a thing. Like, racism is a thing. Like, especially if you're a black dude and you act like racism is not a thing, you've got to be like really, really retarded. You're like ultimate retard. That's why a lot of people don't really like these Red Bull coaches like Donovan Sharp and Coach Greg Adams, because it's like, we see that y'all kind of came up and all this kind of stuff, but you act like it hasn't been like some systematic oppression here and here that has, that's kind of put people where they are, man. And of course, man, a lot of people, they kind of make their own beds at the end of the day. But, man, there still is a lot of factors for the people that actually are trying to have kind of held them down, man. And I ain't going to goddamn act like it's not happening. What do y'all think about that, man? Do y'all think the NFL is as whack as hell? Because I do. Do you think that they should start a whole nother league? I don't know. Like, I know The Rock got that little XFL league. Won't the folks go to the XFL league or something like that, man? Because my client was talking about they should go to the Canadian league or something like that. But that'd just be like more white guy politics, wouldn't it? Because Canada's just America light, ain't it? So it wouldn't really be too much better. But yeah, man, y'all let me know, man. Have you ever played football? Have you had a concussion? Have you, afterwards, have you had some type of, brain injury, memory loss, anything like that? Would you let your kids play football? Yeah, let me know all those things, man. Go on, comment them down below. Y'all have a great day. Y'all go out here and get it, and I'll see y'all next time.